Hi, my name is Mike Doyle. I'm running for the 170th Legislative District in far northeast Philadelphia. And, I wanted to start out by saying a quote of scripture, since I thought it would be appropriate that we're in church. And this is a very important piece to me, and it goes to Matthew 14:14. And Jesus went forth, and he saw a great multitude, and he was moved with compassion, and he healed their sick. The Republicans, for 30 years, had hijacked our most sacred and best loved traditions, one being Christianity. And I firmly believe that all religions should be honored. All. Everyone. And right now, I think that the Republicans forgot what they wanted to do when they hijacked the legislature and tried to become this Christian coalition. And I think that progressives and liberals now truly represent those fundamental ideals of our nation, of helping those who are sick, who need help, who are in need. And I just want to represent that. I think that healthcare for all, single payer, universal healthcare is the way to do that, especially when we, in terms of helping people who suffer from opioid addiction. Being in recovery myself from alcoholism and addiction, I understand how important universal coverage is. We see people going in and out of the system, and our government currently does not have anything set up to help those. 175 people die a day of addiction. We need to stop that. Thank you. So sorry for your loss, like everyone. I think we all have some type of story like that. We're in a class struggle right now. There are people that have everything. They have all the money. They have all the resources. There's not a lot of them, but they have everything. And then there's us. And we struggle. And we have family members that die. And what do we do? It's really a class warfare issue at this point. When I went to D.C. to fight against the repeal of ACA, I risked my body and got arrested because I don't want to hear these stories anymore. I don't want to have to look at my father dying. I don't want to have to hear that your loved one had to die because the right care wasn't given right away. We're in a class warfare right now, and that's what I would do, is fight for your loved one. I thank you very much for your service. You know, nurses are the angels that are on earth with us, and you can never be thanked enough for your service. And I think when I saw people get together and fight that ACA bill, it was the first time in my life where I was like, holy shit, look at this. And they fought it and they beat it. What was happening with these children down in Florida, with these children down in D.C. with DACA, you know, all the unions know, we organize, the people can get together and do whatever we want. The Republicans try to break us up. We need to stick together, in together with solidarity. We are not commodities, we are human beings. And once we start acting like that, then maybe we can get what we want. Thank you. I just had, I went to the dentist for the first time in my life about 3 years ago. And there's a lot of people out there. Look, I'm a regular person. I struggled with addiction my whole life and alcoholism. I know a lot of people out there who are addicts and alcoholics, never been to the dentist. And then they get sober and I go, I gotta do something about it too. I mean, it happens all the time. We hear it all the time. But it's something that most people are afraid to even talk about. There's a stigma behind saying, I've never been to the dentist. So not only am I going to stand up for ending stigma against addicts and alcoholics, I walk in a room and say, I'm an addict and alcoholic all the time. You think people that would support those? The same thing, I've never been to a dentist because I don't have the money. Yes, expand Medicaid included and make it affordable, definitely. Thanks for your question, Anthony, and your little man next to you. Listen, somebody asked me the other day, Mike, why did you want to run for office? And there's a million different reasons. But I said, I'd rather handcuff myself to a bank door than run for office, and it's only been a month. I don't know how people who run for office year after year don't do it. It's a learning process, but listen, you know, whether I get elected or not, I'm gonna be with you. When I see union leaders go to Harrisburg and walk out with cuffs, that's what excites me. That's what I think leadership is, and if it takes getting arrested, I'll be there with you guys, that's all. The wealth and inequality in this country and in this state, the Commonwealth, it's dramatically huge, terrible. And we're at a point in our history where we need to do some radical things. And if we keep electing legislators that are going to be in the middle and moderate, we have to stop doing that. We have to elect people that will do whatever it takes to represent the people, the hardworking people, the regular people, not the wealthy, the 1%.